I feel like I'm committing a crime. My hair is never a blank canvas. My eye is almost better, so that's good. I should not be wearing makeup right now, but fight me. Also, the 1975 are live streaming their entire set on Instagram right now. If they pull anything funny and play Antichrist or something and I miss it, kill me. But what's up guys, it's Alex, and today I'm outside, clearly as I said before, I think. Did I? The lighting looks good here to me, but here it doesn't. Good, bad. Today I'm going to be doing a telling you about my tattoos video. Is that a thing? Is that what those are called? So I'll start with my very first tattoo ever. It was this one.
I don't know if you can, yeah, that one.
It's just kind of like an outline because I was scared when I got my first tattoo. I was also on tour and very sick, so I didn't want to go for anything too crazy. So I just got this little outline and I love it. The meaning behind it, I guess, is I've always watched like Lord of the Rings. Like I literally kind of grew up watching Lord of the Rings and Harry Potter, and it's just kind of represents my childhood in a way because that's kind of what kept me sane. But I do want to get it redone very, very soon. Like no shade at the dude who did it at all because he was nice. It's very, I don't think it's well done. It's just the lines are very not good. It's not a bad tattoo and I still love it. It means a lot to me, but I just would like to get the lines redone, I guess. So the tattoo I got after that was, which one did I get? My Sylvana's Windrunner thigh tattoo.
And I love her, she's beautiful. This tattoo is so detailed, it's ridiculous.
That tattoo took probably about 4 hours.
What?
I'm gonna hope those ants weren't on this little couch I'm sitting on, because my entire body is on here and I'm wearing shorts and I really hope I don't find an ant in mine. So from that tattoo on, I've gotten all of my tattoos from the same person. His name is Kyle Crowell. He's at Torch Tattoo in Anaheim, California. If you guys are in California or like the Orange County area, he's amazing and he's so cool. The next tattoo I got after that, I don't actually remember which one I got next, but I think it was my no face tattoo. And it's pretty small. It's probably like the size of my middle finger. And I got that one because I love Spirited Away. I don't know, No Face was just always my favorite little character from Spirited Away. And the giant baby, but I didn't really want a giant baby tattooed on me. And then I have the little moon. It's really hard to see that, but it's entirely out of dots, and I think that's so cool. And that one literally probably took like 30 minutes. Then I have this one on my finger, which is my star sign. I'm an Aries, but I wanted a tiny finger tattoo. I was like, hey, why not get my my star sign on my finger. My other thigh piece, which is this one. This one took 6 hours and it hurt even worse than that one. So my the reason I got a Corpse Bride daddy. I love Tim Burton movies. I know that's a very stereotypical emo thing to say, but I just flat out love Tim Burton movies, and The Corpse Bride is my absolute favorite Tim Burton movie. I don't know, I just really love the movie. It's cute and it always makes me smile and laugh, and it's just a really good movie. And if you haven't seen it yet, watch it because it's the cutest thing you will ever witness in your life. Moving on to my next arm, I have this. It's like a geometrical flower roses thing. I don't know. It has pretty much no meaning at all. I just really like roses and I love this design. I'm now realizing that most of my tattoos don't have much meaning, but that's okay because I think they look cool.
Oh.
And my last one, I might just have to insert a photo or something. This one has a little bit of a cool backstory. Well, not a little bit. I think it's pretty dope. So in, I forget, like 2-3 years ago, I found this picture on DeviantArt and I was like, wow, I love this drawing. It's so cool. I want to get it tattooed someday. Fast forward a couple years when I'm actually old enough to get tattoos, I was looking through my old phone and I found that picture and I was like, I need this tattooed. I love it. I've wanted it for years. And so I found the artist's Instagram. I direct messaged her and I asked her if it was okay if I were to get her art tattooed on me. And she said it was totally fine and she wanted to see it when it was done. And she also told me that her daughter watches my videos. So that's kind of a cool little twist thing. Twist? Not a twist. I am going to be going back pretty soon. I have an idea for like a Beetlejuice tattoo. And what else? Oh, I'm going to get a poison apple from Snow White because that's also one of my favorite movies. I get a lot of movie tattoos, I realize, or I'm going to get a lot of movie tattoos and video games. So that's just kind of what I'm into, I guess. Next time you see me, well, I guess on my main channel, it'll be out first, but my hair is going to be purple, hopefully. I'm in the process of like taking out the blue and it's pretty much out. There's just a few spots like in here where there's a little bit of blue left, but it should come out pretty easy now since my hair is pretty perfect color for it. So yeah, I think that's all for this video. If you guys enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to Our World Away. I post every Friday, so keep a lookout for me next Friday. I forgot how to outro. Leave a comment, let me know if you have any tattoos, and what your favorite tattoo of mine is, I guess. If you want, you can. Just if you want to. Yeah, don't feel pressured. Oh my God, what am I talking about? So yeah, I'm going to go hope the 1975 are still alive on Instagram and watch the rest of their stream. I hope you guys like this video. All the links to my personal social media is in the description below if you want to follow me. I hope you guys have a good day and a good week and a month, and I will see you next Friday, and bye.